We just received the case from Mallorca, Residency 1, so we are going to verify the facts. This is a patient that we are going to treat, okay, and we are going to do the planning and interdisciplinary planning, and so we can try the mock-up on, see if we have any indications for the case so we can work. So we just got the case and we are going to proceed now with the planning center team.
I have just received the all the information for the case that we will be presenting on the DSD Residency 1 Mallorca. That is happening next week. And I'll start designing the smile frame for her. It's a really interesting case. And I want to show you how we do this process. Come here. So this is the idea. We have all her pictures, her STL files, and the CBCT, everything we need to design a nice smile and some treatment options for her. Our team here, they match the STL with the face. Here, in transparency, you can see that it's matching the position of the STL file, of the upper model to her face. And then we start to design the smile curve that fits her face. Okay, here, we set the midline, and then the smile curve where we think her teeth should be ideally according to her face. Once I have this ready, then this case goes to a designer that will be, I'll show you in a minute. Lorena is our main designer in the DSD interdisciplinary team, and she will be working with this case according to the smile frame that I designed for her. So I have the smile frame ready for her. I will talk to Lorena now to explain to her what are my ideas about this case. We are preparing two options and I will explain to Lorena what she'll be performing on both options, okay? Mask on. Here we have the informal meeting of the interdisciplinary team. Lorena. Here, this is the famous Lorena. Mm-hmm. She will be designing this case. Mm-hmm. And Lorena, so we are planning for this case two options. Okay, so for you to know, one option is we are considering orthognatic surgery. And then the other option, we'll do it more conservative with ortho plus crown lengthening procedure. So you can work in both options and then I check the case with you.
Okay, thank you very much.
We just finished the two options of the case. This is the final outcome of the first option, that is the orthognatic one, and this is the final outcome. And then Manu is giving the final touches of the second option, the just with ortho and crown lengthening procedure. As you can see. And now two options are ready to go to the next step, that is the quality control. So I can talk with Tatiana to proceed with it.
Hola Tatiana, perdón, acabo de terminar las dos opciones del caso, entonces si quieres hacer el quality control ya están listas para...
Genial, para me terminar. Pongo ahora mismo.
Gracias, gracias Lore.
We are finishing the quality control for this case, for the residency in Mallorca. Lorena just finished the design and I did the quality control of the two options for the case. One, as you might remember, one is orthognatic case, surgery case. We are simulating orthognatic surgery for her. And the other one, we go through the limits of ortho plus crown lengthening procedure. And then after finishing this, we start to design the motivational part for the two options. And then we go to print this, the shell and the motivational mockup so we can try in the course. Yes, on Friday we checked the case with Christian. He gave us the okay, proceed. And now we are doing the motivational part of it. So let's let them know. Hello, hola Manu.
Hello.
Ya tenemos el caso, el motivational, mm-hmm. las dos opciones para Mallorca, para que te pongas a preparar los archivos y enviamos a fabricar.
Vale.
So Manu is on charge now. He will prepare all the files so we can send it to the lab so they can print both options and shell and motivational STL file. Gracias, Manu.
Now the shell is done. Manu can show us. And then we can go to the printing lab to talk with Jose Maria because it's needed to print.
Thank you, Manu.
Hola.
Ya te he mandado la. Te hemos mandado las dos shell y los dos motivacionales para imprimir.
Me pongo por ahí.
Perfecto, gracias.
Vale, voy a preparar los shell para el residency y los estoy poniendo digitalmente en Prefab para empezar a imprimir.
¿Cuánto tiempo te lleva hacer esto?
Pues la preparación unos minutos y la impresión un par de horas. Bueno, una vez realizado el generamiento de los soportes, lo que hacemos es mandarlo a la impresora. Entonces cargamos el trabajo y el proceso suele tardar como 2 horas y en 2 horas lo que hacemos es quitar la plataforma, le damos un baño de alcohol para limpiar de restos de resina y acto seguido se introduce en la fotocuradora a 60 grados y unos 20 minutos. Y ya se terminaría de fotocurar y quedaría el proceso realizado.
Para hacer el mockup he mezclado las siliconas base con el catalizador para hacer la llave. Una vez se ha endurecido, he cogido la silicona fluida y lo he puesto por toda la zona de los dientes para marcar bien la forma y transferirlo a boca. Voy a recortar la silicona con la forma de los dientes del shell. Tardaré 20 minutos en hacerlo todo el proceso.
Genial, lo tendremos listo entonces hoy para llevárnoslo mañana a Mallorca,
sí,
¿verdad?
Hoy sale.
Hoy sale listo, uh-huh. Perfecto.
Bueno, como ya han endurecido las dos siliconas, saco el modelo y compruebo que se ha reproducido bien toda la forma y ahora lo recorto. Ya lo tenemos todo listo y ahora ya lo empaquetamos y lo mandamos para Mallorca. Ya tengo el paquete, lo voy a dar a Luquen, que es el que lo va a llevar mañana a Mallorca. Hola, Luquen.
Hola.
Te dejo el trabajo que tienes que llevar mañana a Mallorca.
Perfecto. Aquí va. Gracias.